Hey, so last week, as you know, the European Council presented Ursula von der Leyen, the German, current German defense minister, as the candidate for the European Commission presidency. So basically the head, the boss of the European Commission. At Volt, we were extremely disappointed by this because it didn't follow the Spitzenkandidat process. Ursula von der Leyen doesn't or did never campaign for the support of the European people during the election or before. And so she really came out of nowhere for a lot of citizens and especially also for a lot of people in our movement. But nevertheless, we said, okay, let's keep it open. Let's understand what she actually stands for, what she proposes. And so, because we actually believe it's important in politics to listen to the people and their proposals before we make our judgment. And this is really also irrespective of her personality. But today, she presented herself, Ursula von der Leyen presented herself in front of the Green Group, where we also sit with Volt. And we asked her a lot of questions about a range of topics. And I have to tell you that I really cannot support Ursula von der Leyen's candidacy for the European Commission. This meeting, and we just came out of it, was full of a lot of empty words. She didn't commit on a lot of policy issues. She just didn't commit on anything. So when it comes to economics, when it comes to rule of law, so for example, Poland and Hungary, when it comes to cybersecurity, when it comes to a range of topics, there was just really no proposal, no ideal, no way to go. But what's really even worse for me is that there's this lack of vision, the lack of making somehow use of this great role of the Commission presidency and of putting forward an agenda, an idea of where Europe should go and not just be dictated by national leaders. She was completely lacking that. Volt is standing for such a forward, pragmatic, progressive idea, and she didn't have anything to offer on that perspective. So that is why I really can't vote for her. And I actually also ask all the parliamentarians in this House, in the European Parliament, to also not vote for her and to, together with the Council, see if we can find a stronger candidate for the European Union. And to all the citizens, I would say, look, 2 months of uncertainty until we find another better candidate is something that we have to take and have to just do, because it's really important for us to have a strong Commission president for the next 5 years. So let's keep it together, let's go ahead and let's find a stronger candidate for this role. Thank you.